In this tutorial, we will show how to define a new grid inverter that can be used in the PVsyst simulations based on the data sheets. We will go through the main grid inverter's definitions in PVsyst, which are stored in so-called OND files. The first page of a data sheet describes general features of the grid inverter, which are usually promotional. The second page gives the technical specifications, mainly the input and output characteristics, as well as the efficiency. Sometimes you have columns for models of several powers. It is possible to create new inverters from scratch in the PVsyst database, but in practice, it is much easier to start from a similar component that is already present in the database, modify the main parameters according to the datasheet, and store it under a new name. For this example, we will choose a generic inverter of 30 kW. When opening the inverter or any component in PVsyst, you must define the basic data, which are model, manufacturer, data source, and file name. The convention in PVsyst is to define the file name of an inverter as manufacturer_model.ond. Then you have to find and enter the main parameters on the datasheet. On the input side, the mandatory parameters are marked in bold: minimum and maximum MPP voltage and absolute maximum PV voltage. If you are using automatic efficiency profiles, the power threshold should be at least 0.5% of the nominal power PNOM. You can enter a minimum voltage for PNOM, which is optional and equivalent to an input current limiting. Entering this voltage value will update the corresponding current. You can also enter the current, which will determine the minimum voltage for attaining PNOM. If the inverter has several MPPT inputs, this current is the limit for one single MPPT. The nominal MPP voltage is very rarely specified and not really useful. These values in violet are sometimes specified by the manufacturer. They concern the PV array connected to this inverter. PVsyst doesn't use these limitations, as we consider that they are not relevant for the inverter's sizing. However, if the manufacturer specifies that they affect the warranty of the inverter, you should check required. In this case, PVsyst will issue error messages when these limitations are not met. The main output information is the grid voltage, which may differ from country to country, the grid frequency, and whether the inverter is mono or three-phased. The nominal AC power, named PNOM, is the most relevant property of an inverter. You may define a maximum AC power, which is a nominal power possible when the inverter's temperature is not too high. The current limits are not relevant and not used in the simulations. The page Efficiency Curve shows the DC-AC conversion efficiency as function of DC input power. For the PVsyst database, the manufacturers explicitly specify these curves, often for three different input voltages. However, these values are normally not present on the datasheets. The datasheets just give the maximum efficiency, or an Euro or CC average efficiency. From these values, PVsyst can create automatically an efficiency profile. The additional data page contains information on inverter details, out of which only a few have an impact on the simulation results. One of them is the number of MPPT inputs and possibly specific parameters for unbalanced multi-MPPT inverters. Then there are the night consumption and auxiliaries that play a role when defining the system losses. All other values are not used in the simulations and are for information only. The page Output Parameters contains properties that are relevant for the AC side of the inverter. On the left side, the power factor specifies the capabilities of this inverter for producing reactive energy. Here you should enter whether the PNOM limit is applied to the apparent or the active power. This is not always explicitly specified on the datasheets. The indication will be the units of the PNOM value, which are either kilowatt or KVA, which stands for kilovolt ampere. The group of values on the right side defines the maximum allowed power as function of the inverter's temperature. The max AC power describes the inverter behavior at high temperatures. Many inverters specify a PNOM value and a PMAX value, which represents an increased inverter power that can be reached up to a given temperature threshold. You may also define derate factors for very high temperatures. The maximum AC power is specified on the main parameters page. If it is higher than the PNOM value, the checkbox allows overpower will be enabled. If you tick this checkbox, you have to define the maximum temperature for PMAX and the temperature for PNOM. The diagram on the bottom will be updated accordingly. The manufacturer may also define high operating temperature limitations. Please note that to reflect this temperature behavior correctly in the simulation, you also need to define the inverter's operating temperature during the simulation. This is done in the project definitions via the dialog Energy Management. The Sizes and Technology page contains additional descriptions of the inverter. The field Technology Specificities allows to enter specific features of the inverter as free text. The fields in Operating Conditions, Behavior at Limits should not be modified. They are useful only for very old or special inverter types. Now the inverter is fully defined. When exiting this dialog, PVSYS will prompt you to save your modifications. Clicking on Save As will store this new OND file in your PVSYS workspace. You will be able to use it in your projects.